Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. Okay, Alzheimer's disease is the sixth leading cause of death in the United States. And for this reason, the month of June has been deemed Alzheimer's and Brain Awareness Month. Stephanie Baker from Alzheimer's Association joins us. It's funny, I was listening to public radio on the way in today, and they're talking about the mortality rate has changed in the negative direction for the first time in like 10 years or something, and they attributed some of that to Alzheimer's disease.
Yeah, so Alzheimer's disease is the sixth leading cause of the death in the United States, and among the top 10, it's the only one without a way to cure it, prevent it, or slow the progression of the disease. And so this month in June, we talk about Alzheimer's and Brain Health Awareness Month to not only bring light to brain health, but also to Alzheimer's disease and the effect on our society.
Do we see this more often because we know what it is and we recognize it more, or is it something about our lifestyle and things we can do to help?
So we are getting older, our population is aging, and that's one of the primary risk factors, although Alzheimer's disease is not a normal part of aging. But there are some things that we can take into account to really make sure we're doing to keep positive brain health in our life. We talk about 10 things to do, 10 ways to love your brain. Mm-hmm. And I did want to mention four lifestyle factors that we can all take into account, make gradual changes in our lives. One is to make sure we're breaking a sweat. We want to have cardiovascular activity in our life.
So if you're passive, you could be more prone to this.
We really want it. It's really good for your brain health to keep the brain, to keep the blood flow moving, keep your heart beating. Also nutrition, things that our doctor have probably already talked to us about a mm-hmm. little bit, and making sure we're eating those fruits and vegetables in our diet.
So fruits and vegetables, that would be the thing, the way to step that side of your diet up.
Yeah, absolutely. And also the idea to really have cognitive activity in our lives. So it doesn't necessarily mean we all have to go out and do a really hard crossword puzzle, but to do something challenging. So maybe you're gonna take a cooking class or learn a new language. Mm-hmm. And all of these things we can do with other people.
Whenever, social aspects.
Yeah, absolutely. Whenever we can buddy up, that's a great way to keep the brain healthy and to really make sure we're doing things for our brain health.
I know, I see a lot of, I know there's early onset of Alzheimer's and we hear about that, but I see an awful lot of young people when they forget about something or they become a little confused or forgetful, all of a sudden they're scared and they're worried about this. Is this something that people should be worried about, or are people just so aware of it now that they're paranoid?
It is something that people become worried about as they age, but I think it's important for us to know that there is help out there. So if you're somebody who is noticing some warning signs in yourself and could just ask a couple questions, need someone to talk to, or maybe a caregiver who is really living this every day and caring for someone, we do have support there for those individuals.
How about support for the people who are the caregivers or the people who are just starting to recognize that maybe one of their relatives or a loved one has a problem like this?
So there's a 24/7 helpline. The Alzheimer's Association never closes. You can call 1-800-272-3900, and we can answer questions that people might have on anything in that area. There's support groups and education programs.
Mm-hmm. So is this something that people should fear, or something that you could start to build up immunity toward?
Well, I think it's important to be aware about it, but also to know that if it is something that starts to inhibit your life, that there are supports out there. And this is a great month for people to really raise awareness about Alzheimer's disease and go out to participate in a fundraiser event. There's a number of events going on in the Cleveland area.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you so much for having
me. Don't forget, right? Natalie?